Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi and today we are going to discuss about histograms. Basically, we are going to see that what are histograms and basically how do we make them, okay? So for that, firstly, I would be telling you about all the required, you can say, requirements for the histograms, and after that, we would be seeing one example, okay? Let's get started for that. Okay, so now what should I do? Firstly, let us write a heading that it's histogram and we are gonna see about histogram. So basically in the last video, I have already told you about the bar plots, stem and leaf plot, and we have even discussed the line plot, right? So there is a very basic difference between the, you can say, between the diagram of histogram and bar plot. Okay, so just let me make that clear first. Let's say we are just having x and y axis, two x and y axis, okay? So the first one, let's say I'm making bar plots. So what we make, we basically make bar plots like this, okay? We just make different, you can say, like we make different bars here. But what's the thing in histogram? That we just make continuous bars. So if I would be making like something like this, okay? So this is my histogram because it has my continuous plots. And in bar plot, what we have a distance between every plot, okay? So this is a very basic difference between the histogram and bar plot. And if you're gonna like see the example, and if you're gonna get some pictures, for one says bar graph and one says histogram, so now you can just have a look and you can now just tell by seeing only that what is the bar graph and what is the histogram, okay? So this was the like difference between the images, and this is the basic difference of drawing, like how we draw bar plots and how we draw histograms, okay? Just let me erase this thing and let's move towards the histogram definition, because we are going to see what is a histogram today. And just let me have a different color and let's get started for that. Okay, so here I will be writing a definition for the histogram. So basically it's very simple that what is histogram. So histogram, and let's write that also. Histogram consists of, and this is the same thing which I have just told you, I'm writing that only, okay. Consist, okay, just let me write the correct spelling. C-O-N, it's C-O-N-S-I-S-T, okay. Histogram consists of continuous plots. Okay, so I would be writing continuous, okay, continuous plots. So this was the main like basic difference which I have just told you, like when we are making some plot like this, let's say this is my x and y axis, and here I would, let's say I am making some graphs like that which are continuous, right? We are not giving any spaces between these. So this is basically called as histogram, okay? So this is basically known as a histogram, right? So now whenever we make something, let's say we have any plots or we have any graphs, so basically what we have necessary like important thing, that and that was x and y axis, okay? That is x and y axis. So this is the same thing in histograms also. We basically have x and y axis. Now what we just write in the x axis and what we write in the y axis, let's just see that, okay? So here I would be writing x axis for the x axis. So for x axis, we write that whatever the data represents, okay? Let's say I have data for, you can just for some students, right? So on the x axis, I would be just writing that students, okay? So this is how on x axis we write, and let me just write that x, like we write whatever, it's whatever the data represents, okay? Whatever the data represents. Okay, so this was about the x-axis. Now let's move towards the y-axis, and just let me tell you that what does this like y-axis do. So basically what we do on y-axis, in y-axis we write frequency or relative frequency. Now I would just tell you that what is relative frequency, but just let me write that. So it's frequency or relative frequency, or it's relative frequency, okay? FREQUENCY. And yeah, I'm writing all these things because I hope you all must be writing the things with me so that you are all having the proper notes, okay? So this was about the x and y axis. So basically on x, we have that whatever our data represents, we have that thing, right? We represent that thing on x. And on the y axis, we represent the frequency, or you can just frequency or its relative frequency. Now what is this relative frequency? Now just let me give a definition for that, and let's change the color. And let's say we take a green color, okay? So I would be writing here relative frequency. Relative frequency. After that, I would be just telling you about the formula. There is one formula for finding relative frequency also, okay? So let's say I have written relative frequency relative frequency is equal to the frequency, its frequency of observed values, and here I am just putting the divided sign, okay, divided by number of data values. So like from the very starting we are seeing that what about the data values. So basically we represent that data values from n, right? We basically write small n, and this we are seeing from the very starting of this course, okay? So this data values are n, okay? That is my that are total number of data values which I have in my data, which I will just taking it, okay? So just let me revise the definition that relative frequency is equal to the frequency of observed values divided by number of data. So here what I have written, I have just written definition and even the formula. So if I just want to just write the formula from here only, so how will I do that? Just let me change the color. So I would write that relative frequency, and let's say we are going to write RF, okay? Relative frequency is equal to frequency of observed values. So frequency is just denoted by F, okay? So I just wrote F. Now what I have written? Frequency of observed value divided by number of total number of data values. So now my total number of data values is just denoted by N. So here we know, here we have our formula for the relative frequency, okay? So this is the formula for relative frequency, right? Now what I will be just telling you, and here I have already told that this F is pointing to frequency, and just let me write that once more, and this N is pointing to total number, I'll be writing data values, okay? You can just have a look that it is total number of data values, but I would just write data values. And this RF, so you all know that it is relative, and relative frequency, okay? Frequency. So this was the formula about relative frequency, and relative frequency is equal to F upon N. And this relative frequency is basically written on the y-axis of the histogram, which I just told you. Now, let's say I take an example. Let's say I have F is equal to 3, okay? My frequency is equal to 3. I have N data points that are 40. Now, if I just want to find out my relative frequency, so I will write relative frequency is equal to 3 by 40. And in the final answer, I would be getting 0.015. So this would be my relative frequency, and it is that simple to find out. Okay, so this was about the histogram. Just let me tell you, and after that we are going to see one example that how to make plots for histogram. Okay, so histogram consists of continuous plots, and that is what I just told you. And what we represent on x and y. So basically on x axis I write whatever the data represents, okay? Whatever my data is representing, I write that thing on my x axis. And basically on my y axis, what I write, I wrote frequency or relative frequency, okay? So now what is this relative frequency? Relative frequency is equal to the frequency of observed values divided by number of data values. So the formula is relative frequency is equal to frequency upon frequency divided by total number of data values. And here we have just taken an example that if f is equal to 3, n is equal to 40, then relative frequency we would divide this 3 by 40, and here we'll be getting the answer. Okay, so this is about the relative frequency. Now here I just have an example for you all, and let me write it as question. Okay, so now we will be just discussing this question that how to just solve it. Okay, so this is the question. Now just let me take the highlighter because I would not be using the pen here. Okay, let's take yellow one, and okay, fine. So what I have the question, the following data are the heights in inches to the nearest half inch of 100 male semi-professional soccer players. Okay, the heights are continuous data since height is measured. So I have this much of data here. Okay, so this is all my data which I have here. Now this data is for 100 male semi-professional. So basically what is it? So what is the N? N is 100, right? So this is the total data. Now if I want to just make the histogram for this data, so how will I do that? We will be going to see that thing, okay? So how to make the histogram if I have such data like this, okay? Just let me take the color, and let's say I would be taking this one, okay? Let's move forward, and sorry, I just forgot to take the pen, and here we have pen, and okay. Okay, so let me go down. I hope by the time you have just read the question one more time. So let me go down and let's start writing from here. Now, there is one thing in the histogram, there's one rule in the histogram that whatever is your first sample, whatever is the first sample you would be taking, that should be less than your first data point. I should repeat that. Whatever the first sample that you would be taking will be less than your first data point. So let's say in our case, first smallest data point is 60, right? So now I would be needing a data like the sample data point which is less than 60. So for that, what I would do now, just see. So let's write everything in a very detail that here the smallest value, is 60, right? That I just showed you that the smallest value is 60. Now what I was saying that I would be taking a less value that is from 60 because I would be taking a less sample value that is like I would be taking a less sample value from 60. Now basically what we do, we have some like you can say like previous data. So let's say that I would be writing since 0.5 comma 0.05 comma 0.005 etc. These are the values which are very convenient to use. Okay, now just let me erase this thing R, and in the next line I would be writing are convenient. Convenient. Okay, if I just missed the spelling, so just ignore that. Here we are just seeing the concept that how to apply that. Okay, so since 0.5, 0.0, and these are convenient to use. Now what I would be doing here, I would be just subtracting the 0.0. I would be taking the 0.05. okay, so let's say that I'd be writing take 0.05. now I would be just subtracting the 0.05 from 60. Okay, because I told that we would be wanting the first sample which should be less than our first smallest value, right? Our smallest value, that whatever is the smallest value in my data, the first sample should be less than that. So my smallest value here in my data is 60. Now, so what I would do, I would quickly subtract the 60 minus 0.05. Okay, like because why I just use this, because it can be a very convenient point to start. Okay, so I would be writing 60 minus 0.05, and here I would be getting 59.95. okay, I would be sorry, just let me write it in a neater handwriting, and what I would be getting is 59.95 after subtracting of 60 minus 0.05, right? So this is the thing that I would be getting. Now I got the output that is from here 59.95. so now I would just treat my 59.95 as my starting point. Okay, as I told you that we would be needing a starting point which is the less than our smallest value, right? I told you that thing. So here I would be treating this 59.95 as my starting value. Now just keep this thing in mind and just note all the things with me only, right? Now what I would be doing, as I just did for my smallest value, I would be doing the same thing for my largest value. But for my largest value, I would be needing an ending value that is greater than my largest value. So in my data, the largest value is 74. If you have noticed, well and good. If you haven't, just let me show you that thing. Okay, let me go above, and here is our data. So just see that the last data which is present is 74, right? So my 74 is the largest value in my data. Now what I would be doing, I would be just adding some value in this. So let's say I have just subtracted 0.05. So I would be just adding the same thing only, and I would be writing 74 plus 0.05. Now why I have done this, I am again repeating the reason, because I wanted the starting value to be less than my smallest value, and I wanted the ending value which is to be greater than my largest value. And why I am wanting these things, you will just get it, just know it in a little while. Okay, so here my output would be 74.05 after the addition, right? So these, so 59.95 is my starting value and the 74.05 is my ending value, right? So I would be ending my value at this point only, right? So this is done. Now what comes next? Now what the comes next thing is that how much difference I should give. Let's say we have taken an example, and here I have just plotted this plot, okay? I'm just doing it roughly. Let's say how will I just get to know that I need to take difference between 2, 4, 6, 8, 10? How will I get to know that? What is the difference between, like, what should difference I should take between two plots, right? So for that, we would be calculating the width. That for that, like, for knowing that thing, you would be calculating the width for the bar, for the histograms which we will be plotting. Okay, so for that, for calculating the width, how would I do that? So I would write calculating the width. Okay, I would be writing calculating the width. Now I would be just doing one thing, that is, I would be using my largest ending value. My ending value is 74.05. What I would be doing, I would be subtracting my starting value. My starting value is 59.95. And what I would be doing, I would be just dividing it by 8. Now, what is this 8? 8 is the total samples. Like, okay, let me go above side once more and let me just tell you. Okay, so here this total sample means I have one value of 60, then 60.5, then I have 61, 61.5, and the things like that. Okay, so it is just going from 60 to 74. So here just I use that 8. Okay, so this is how we calculate the width, and I just divided it by 8, and after doing that, I would be getting the output 1.76. okay, so this is how I got 1.76. now when I would be using this for finding the actual distance, so I would just round up it to 2. Okay, I would be just considering it round up 2. Okay, I would just considering it as 2, because like we just round off the values. Okay, so I would just considering 1.76 to 2. Now what I would be doing, I would be just finding out the boundaries. Boundaries in the sense that what are the values that I should mention here. Okay, boundaries are just have a little bit more focus than you were before, because we are just moving at the last of this question. Okay, so now my first value was, my starting value was 59.95. now this is done. Now what I would be doing, I would be just adding plus 2 in my values. Why I would be adding? Because here just now I told you that I found the width for my graphs. Okay, so now the width, whatever is the width for my graphs, I would be just adding that much value in my every number. Okay, so I had done 59.95 plus 2. So here what I would get, 61.95, right? Just let me write all these things, and then I will let you know what I am just trying to do here. And I would write 61.95 plus 2, and that would be 63.95. okay, now what I would do, 63.95 plus 2, and that would be 65.95. okay, now next, 65.95 again plus 2 is equal to 67.95. now I'm writing just this side, okay, because I just want to make it in a single one so that I can explain. Then after that, it would be 67.95 plus 2, and it would be 69.95. now I'd be writing 69.95 plus 2, and that would be 71.95. okay, now I'll be writing 71.95 plus 2, and that would be 73.95. okay, and now I go for last. Now last is 73.95 plus 2, and that would be equal to 75.95. now just have a look at what I am doing here. Now I found the boundaries, right? I just founded out the boundaries, that what are the boundaries for my histogram. Now how will I plot this? Just let me take a highlighter for that thing. First, my first value for my boundary would be 59.95, as we have just calculated in the starting. Okay, that I have just calculated. Now my first histogram, my first hist plot will be going from 59.95 to 61.95. now what I just mean by this thing, just let me explain this thing, and just let me have a different color for explaining that. And let's say I would be taking black only. Okay, let's say here I have just made this plot. Okay, let's say this is my plot, this is my y axis, and this is my x axis. Okay, now what I would be doing here, I would be just writing 59.95. I would be starting my first point to 59.95, then my second point would be 61.95. Then my third point would be 63.95. Then my fourth point would be 65.95, and it will go till 75.95. And this was the thing that I was just saying, that I would be finding out the boundaries. So this is just meant by boundaries, that I just wanted to find 59, like what, from where should we start and from where should I end. Okay, so this was about finding the boundaries, which I was just doing right now. And for finding the boundaries only, I just calculated the above thing, and that just like we have rounded off 1.76 to 2. Okay, I just calculated the width. So this is done. Now what is this left? Now the last thing that is left is for plotting our histogram, right? Now here I would be just making x and y axis. So like I would be doing this using this one, and just let me take a black color for now. Okay, so like, okay, and where's that? Okay, done. And now here I would be just making something. Okay, so I would be writing something like that, something like this. Okay, and just let me go a little bit. Okay, I can't do that. So let me go down. Okay, fine. Right? Now I will be just using the same color only. Now what I will be doing, as I told that on the Y, what I would write the frequency, and that is relative frequency. Now, here not, I'm not going to find out the relative frequency, because I have already told you how to find the relative frequency. So you would be doing that thing on your own. Now what I am going to do here is that I would be simply writing the points here. Okay, so this point is a zero, you all know, like from here only this is zero. Okay, now my 59.95 from start will start from within here only. Okay, now it will go till 61.95. next what I would be having, let's say here I have the 63.95. I'm just writing this point value below, otherwise it will create a mess up. Okay, now this is 63.95, then after 63 I have 65.95, right? Then I have 67.95. now what I have 69.95, then I have 71.95, then I have 73.95, and at last I have 75.95, right? So this was about the x-axis. Now just let me do the first one also a little bit clearer, and just let me rewrite these both. Okay, so let's have that black color and where it has gone. Okay, so this was 61.95 and this was 59.95. So we have just started from 59 and we have just ended till 75.95. So this was that boundaries which I was just telling you. Now what about the relative frequency? So relative frequency, I have just told you how to find that. So you will be finding, and here I would be writing for the relative frequency for this, and just let me make it neater and just let me write all the things in a proper way. Okay, now I'm just taking a new color, and let's say it is green. Now I'm writing zero here. As I have started from 0.05, the first one is 0.05. now what is my second? Now second must be 0.1, and it is 0.1, it is 0.15, it is 0.2, then it is 0.25, and then okay, I can just go a little bit up, right? And yeah, I can just utilize this space also. It's 0.25, then I have 0.3, then it's 0.35, and then it's 0.4. okay, so this was our relative frequency. Now what I would be doing, I would just plotting my histogram. Okay, so for that I will be just taking my highlighter, and let's say my highlighter is okay, fine. Now how I would be doing that thing, just let's see here. Here this is my question. Now what is my first limit? My first limit is 59.95 to 61.95. now what I would be doing, I would be taking all the values which lie between this point. Okay, so there are total 5 values which lie between 59.95 and 61.95. okay, so these are starting first values. So I would just count the values, so they are 5. Now what I would do, I would just make this histogram, right? I would be just making this histogram from this boundary till this boundary, and here this is my 0.5, right? I just hold on, just let me erase that. Okay, so it is something from here, okay, not from here also, it is from here only. Okay, so this is my first boundary. First boundary, that is my first histogram, which I have just plotted for the all the points that lie between 59.95 to 61.95. Now let's do the same thing for the second one also. Now here what I would be doing is, let me go upside. Now here I would be taking my point 61.5. It would be like 61.5 to 61.95 to 63.95. So in that category I have three points, these three points, right? So now I will be plotting it for only of the three. So now that would be little bit less than, so just let me take a thinner highlighter, and here we have, it would be just something low than 5, right? Because I have only till 0.3. okay, so this is done. Now what I would be doing, I would be doing the same thing for all of my points, whichever the points I have here, right? Now I will be just taking again, and here I will be having one that big marker, and now my third point is still 0.15. okay, so it is still 0.15, and just let me go a little bit upside first. Okay, and it is still 0.15. this third one is from here to here, and this one is my third point. Okay, so this is done. I have total 15 values. Okay, now what I have, I have total this and now this, like this one is for here till here only. So this is like basically covering the whole it is going till the maximum point whatever I have in my graph. Okay, just let me color this thing. Okay, now what is the next is from 65 to, like here I have points from till 0.17. okay, like I have just calculated them before so that the time would not be wasted here, and I have just shown you an example how do we do that, so you can just calculate the points that side. Okay, then I have 0.12, and then this is from 0.12, and here we go. Now then I have 0.07, so 0.07 is a little bit upper than 5, so here it goes. And now at last I have my point as 0.01, so I would be just taking a very thin highlighter so that, okay, so it is something here only, right? So this is my last point is 0.01. so this is about this is how we plot our histogram. Okay, so this is the way we plot histograms. Now just let me make it a clearer one. Okay, now this, and after that this, then this one, after that this one, then this, and here finally this one. So this is basically how we make our histogram, and even if you want, you can just differentiate the lines from here also. And this is our complete histogram, and this is how you, if you get a question to find a histogram, to make a histogram, and you are just given some data, so this is how you will find the histogram. Okay, you will just make the histogram, you will calculate the things, and you will calculate the firstly you will do like smallest value you will check, then after that largest value, and you will just minus 0.05 and plus 0.05, then you will calculate the weight, then the boundaries, and finally you will plot the histogram. So I hope you got the point that how we just make histograms in our data sets, if we are just get that. And basically this is a part of the descriptive statistics. Okay, so this is how we make the histogram for larger data sets. So I hope you just got the points, and if you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment box, or even you can just rewatch the videos. Okay, so this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and bye bye.